What's up, guys? It is Fun Man 3x13 here, Tim, bringing you a nice commentary from the map Overwatch. And I'm just going to be using that USAS 12 shotgun that I love so much now. I just started using it, I love it. And it's a pretty fun gameplay, not the highest kill death ratio. I'm just going to start off in the middle of the game, get past some of the boring parts. I'm going to be using Juggernaut this game. It's very fun, crap loads of assist, but I still love the game mode. I thought you guys would too, so that's why I decided to bring it to you. But what I'm going to be talking about right now is the map packs in Modern Warfare 3, what they could bring. I know I already did a map pack commentary, but some people left me some comments back and some messages that said what I should talk about right now. And first of all, what I'm going to get to is the gun packs. The gun packs are something I brought up. I'm 99.9% sure from multiple sources, I'm not going to name them sources, but that they're real. I can't even remember the sources really, so, but there's quite a few of them, that the map packs are going to come out for gun packs, and here's some of the weapons that people have left me, and I thought that would be good. The first ones I'm going to start with are like the bigger ones, the AUG. I mean, not big, like the bigger guns, like light machine guns, assault rifles. The AUG is the one. I thought that was a great gun in Modern Warfare 2. Not many people knew about it being that great of a gun, so that's why not people didn't use it. The RPD, I just fought that one a while ago, and I thought I would share that one. The RPD, that's been around since COD 4, and it's a great gun, and I wish they would have brought that one back in this game. I actually like a light machine gun. And, that's about it I have for the heavier guns. That's all I can think of off the top of my mind anyway. Then were some pretty good guns. If you guys have any other guns, just leave me some feedback. I might have to do a third commentary on this. It's just so much to fit into one. But the other weapons I came up with are the AK-74U. Not a weapon that a lot of people like, a lot of people have used. A lot of people say now that people use that gun have small penises. But I really don't use it, but it's a pretty good gun anyway. I didn't really use it either, but still liked it a lot. The other weapon is the big one, big good gun that everyone loves. Well, not haters, just people that would want back overall is the Intervention, which is kind of like the MSR, but I still think I like the Intervention better than the MSR from Modern Warfare 2. Now, the Intervention would be pretty great, but the whole thing that I don't get about this whole map pack thing is how are they gonna work? Like, can you use them in normal lobbies, or do you have to be in like these DLC lobbies like this to be able to use them? That's the part that I don't like about them. And can people pick them up? Can people somehow just get the ammo? You know, what's gonna be going on with that? I don't really know, but pretty fun. I think it would be for the map packs to be gun packs. Change it up a little bit. Now, The next thing I'm going to be talking about is the new maps. And I got a story at the end to share with you guys that happened to me this weekend. It's pretty funny, but you know, let's wait till the end. But the new maps, what are going to go on in the new maps? What are some of the things? I already talked about that and got a lot to that. But what this can mean for the maps, I got quite a few ideas from that. I don't really know how to explain this, but a lot of people have been saying that the maps are going to be either really, really open, like Wasteland, or really, really closed in. You know, a really closed in map. This map was perfect, but I would like maps like this that you can snipe on, that you can just use shotguns on, as such as I am doing. Snipe, shotguns, assault rifles, all the things work on the same map. This is the kind of map I like. Awesome job once again for them. But that's what I've been hearing about a lot of, which isn't what I want, because a lot of these map packs have been coming out for the last, I don't know, 3 years, haven't been really the greatest maps. They haven't put a lot of time into them because of how many they're taking out. Now, if they would take time like they did in Modern Warfare 2, well, Modern Warfare 2, they did take a lot of time into them, but they weren't really the greatest. I mean, I like Carnival, that was a pretty good map, but they just put the map packs from COD 4 in there for the maps. All they had to do was redesign it, which isn't that much. But I would like them to do that, think about that, just put some more time into it, get a little bit more better at it. But they could take a few maps in Modern Warfare 2, if you ask me, and put them in this game. Such as a map that's kind of like this, High Rise. High Rise, I'd love. I'd love COD 4 Crossfire. That's another map that I would love. COD 4 Crossfire. Thumbs up for that. That's a good map. If you guys don't have COD 4, it's a big open sniping map. It's my 100% favorite map in all of Call of Duty, I think, was that. Besides this map after this. This new map, I love. I love this map, once again. So, them were my ideas. I think they should take the map packs from Modern Warfare 2, so maybe some more from COD 4, put them in this game. That would be pretty fun. Tell me if you guys think that's a good idea. I mean, not much effort, but, you know, still pretty good. And this could actually help the other Call of Duties. One more, I'm going to go back to the gun pack for one more thing before I tell my short little story time. Is that the map packs could spread to future Call of Duties. Like, if the gun packs come out in this game, who says that they're not going to come out in the next Call of Duty, like Black Ops 2? Or the Call of Duties after that, like Iron Wolf and stuff. You know, that could spread and create a chain reaction that might either ruin or it might highly improve the DLC quality, which I would love, and that guy just made me mad with that knife. Damn it. Anal Nazi. But, I could either do that. But, now to my story from this weekend. We were playing this stupid game out in the woods at my friend's house called Apaches versus Pilgrims. I don't know. We just randomly came up with it. It was kind of stupid, but I think I kind of liked it. We were just, like, throwing sticks at each other and stuff. And my friend told me to ride my bike home and get my BB gun, so I did that. It's just a cheap $20 one. I had my really nice one, but I wasn't going to bring that because I couldn't really carry that on my bike. But he told me to do that, so I did. I brought that back. We started firing at each other, you know, having some fun. This one kid just, like, flanks us, goes and grabs his, grabs it, hip fires me from 50 yards away after I called truce with him, because I knew he could overrun me with that gun. After I called truce, he's like, oh, I'm just going to do one more shot. He shot me right in my freaking ear, and I don't know if that BB is still in my ear or not. It hurts a lot. So if you guys don't hear from me for a while, you know, I'm going to be in a lot of pain. No. Just a little bit of BB stuck in my ear, because I'm not going to the hospital, so I'm not going to tell my parents or whatever, but yeah, it was a pretty fun week, and we actually made a works bomb. If you don't know what that is, you take works toilet bowl cleaner, sorry parents for telling this to your kids, and you drop a little tiny ball of aluminum foil in it, and it explodes and makes a huge boom. It sounded like a gunshot. All the neighbors heard it. But anyway, I hope you guys enjoyed this commentary. This is kind of the short notice commentary. I kind of liked it. Sorry about me taking a break last night, guys. But thank you guys for watching. Hope you enjoyed. Please comment, rate, subscribe. I'm out.